everyone, I'm Chelsea White of Chell Sweets, and I'm here today to show you how to make a honey roasted peanut butter cake. So this is a very classic four layer cake, but the hero ingredient today is going to be honey roasted peanut butter. And as if peanut butter wasn't already good enough by itself, honey roasted peanut butter is even better. So we're going to go ahead and get started stacking the cake layers, and then we'll be going on the decoration. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in so you guys can see exactly what I'm doing as I assemble a cake. And if you guys have any questions while I'm frosting or decorating this cake about either this cake in particular, or baking, or me, feel free to ask in the comments. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started now, adding my cake layers. So we're gonna go ahead and just nestle this right in the center of our cake base. Go ahead and set my parchment paper aside. And we're gonna take a nice big dollop of our buttercream here. And this is a classic American buttercream. If you prefer Swiss meringue, you can totally use that as well. And this is honey roasted peanut butter buttercream that I've also added a little bit of cocoa to just to amp it up a little bit more. So I'm gonna go ahead now and use my offset spatula just to spread an even layer of frosting. And I really like a lot of frosting, and my friends tonight that are helping me live stream also do, so we're adding a lot onto this cake. However, if you like less frosting or don't have a huge sweet tooth, you can always add less, or you could even do a naked cake. Those are great alternatives to cut back on the frosting a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and get a nice smooth layer here. And I like to do that just by kind of spinning my cake base while holding down my offset spatula and then scraping off the excess. So in between each layer, we're going to be adding some chopped up chocolate chips, some chopped up peanut butter chips, and also some honey roasted peanuts. And this is gonna give the cake a really great texture when you bite into it. So we're just gonna go ahead and sprinkle this around in a pretty even layer. And first we're gonna do the chopped up chips, and then we'll get going on the peanuts. So if you have a peanut allergy, this cake is definitely not for you, I'm really sorry. You could probably try it with a different kind of nut inspiration. Some people are allergic to peanuts but not almonds, or vice versa, so you could definitely alter this to fit your needs. So now that we have all of those on there, we're gonna go ahead and add on our honey roasted peanuts. So I'm just gonna do a little sprinkle of these as well. So this is really gonna give the cake a great bite when we cut into it and eat it later. So we're gonna repeat this process with our remaining cake layers, and it's gonna be a pretty tall cake because we are making it with four layers, so it's really gonna get some height on it. And I kind of like that. I think it really looks pretty when there's tall cakes, but if you prefer shorter cakes, or you just aren't trying to feed that many people, you can always modify this to half the recipe to just make it two layers. Or you could even make smaller cake rounds. These are 8-inch cake rounds, and you could definitely half the recipe and make it with 6-inch cake rounds. So that's always an option as well. Are there any questions out there?
We actually have a few questions online asking about where the recipes are housed.
Oh, of course. So the recipes for this cake, this buttercream, everything, are up on chellsweets.com, and that's chellsweets.com, just like my Facebook name, which is tagged at the top of this live video. So if you're interested in this cake or this frosting, feel free to head over there and check out the recipe. I just posted it earlier today. So we're going to go ahead now and add on our toppings again. And for anyone who is just joining, this is I kind of want to call it a peanut butter lover's cake, but it is a honey roasted peanut butter cake that just is all things peanut butter. I added some peanut butter to the cake base, and we're also using a honey roasted peanut butter buttercream. So it's really going to taste amazing and super peanut buttery. Any other questions?
Yeah, can we use crunchy peanut butter for the frosting?
You absolutely can. I think it might make it a little bit more difficult to get smooth sides on the cake, but it also could add a really fun texture to the outside of the cake, so that's definitely an option, and especially if it's your preference, then feel free to do that. So we're going to go ahead and kind of nestle this down to make sure that really all of those pieces that we just added are nice and firm in the frosting. We're going to repeat this one more time, and then we'll get going frosting the exterior of the cake. So as you can see, this is getting very tall. And luckily I have a lot of friends here tonight to share it with, because it's going to feed an army. So I'm going to go ahead and keep frosting. Any other questions?
Yeah, there's a question asking if the cake layers were yellow cake, or what is specifically the cake layer?
So this is my favorite vanilla layer cake recipe, and it's kind of like a buttermilk cake base, I like to call it. It's a little bit more dense than a sponge cake, but it has an amazing flavor and it bakes perfectly flat. You guys can see that I didn't level any of my layers today. They just come out of the oven like that. So I really prefer this recipe because you don't waste any cake trimming the tops off. It just makes the process a lot easier and less wasteful. So it's my go-to vanilla cake recipe, and I highly recommend it if you are looking for a cake recipe. And for today's cake, I just replaced a half a cup of butter with a half a cup of peanut butter to really give it that great peanutty taste. So I'm gonna go ahead now and add on some more of these honey roasted peanuts. And then we're gonna add on our last cake layer. So whenever I add on my last cake layer, I always like to flip it upside down. And that's just because you know that the base of the cake layer baked against the pan, so it's nice and flat, and it's easier to get sharp edges that way. So I'm gonna go ahead and press down now just to make sure that the cake is really nice and firmly stacked. And this is when I also like to make sure that my layers are nice and aligned. And a trick to do this is also you can use your cake bench and just kind of make sure that your layers are lined up. I always call it a cake bench, but it's really a bench scraper. I think I invented that name. All right, so I have a ton of frosting here, and we're gonna be filling in all these gaps and trying to smooth out our frosting to make nice smooth sides. So when I frost a cake, I always like to start at the top and work my way down. So again, we're gonna be putting a lot of frosting on here because we really wanna get the sides fully covered. And again, if you're not this big of a frosting fan or you don't have as big of a sweet tooth as we do, you can definitely make this a naked cake, or you could do a semi-naked cake and apply a thin layer of frosting. There's a lot of different things you could do with this. And also, it's always best practice to add a crumb coat first, let chill that, and then apply a second layer of frosting. But today, in the interest of time, since this is a live stream, we're only going to be doing one layer of frosting. So I'm just gonna gently work my way around the cake, filling in these gaps until we get to the base. So we're gonna be gentle here because we don't wanna topple over our layers, but we do wanna fill in those gaps. Any other questions out there?
Yeah, someone wants to know, do you need dowels to keep the cake from falling?
You can. If you think your cake is really wiggly or you're struggling to keep your layers kind of aligned as you do this, you could use a dowel. And it can definitely help with making the frosting process a little bit easier. But if you're able to do it without one, I recommend doing that, because when you stick a dowel in, you are essentially like cutting out that part of the cake, which isn't that big, but it's just not as fun that way. So I prefer to not use dowels when I don't have to, but it is always an option.
What kind of peanut butter is best to bake with?
Today honey roasted peanut butter is the star, and you can get it freshly ground at Whole Foods. I think you can also buy it as well. But it's all about your preference, I think, because you're gonna like whatever you prefer. So I also really like creamy peanut butter, which is what I normally bake with. But if you love chunky, definitely go for that. So we're almost done applying our frosting here. And I always like to apply a lot of frosting around the cake and then smooth it with my bench scraper. So we're gonna add on quite a bit here, but we are going to be scraping some of it off. So not too much though, we do want a lot on here. Any other questions?
Yeah, what's your favorite part of the baking process?
I would have to say, I know this sounds crazy, but my favorite part is actually cutting into the cakes that I decorate. Usually because I've done a fun pattern inside, or it's a new flavor and I can't wait to try it. So for me, that's actually the most rewarding part. I think a lot of people would disagree with me on that. And I think a lot of people actually dislike that part because they're kind of cutting open their work, but that's always my favorite part, so. All right, so now that we have a pretty even layer of frosting, I'm gonna add a little bit more to these places where we have little holes. We're gonna go ahead and smooth with our bench scraper. I'm going to set this aside, and we're going to take our bench scraper now, and we're just going to set it level to our cake base, and we're going to gently apply pressure and just spin the cake around. So in this part, I kind of like to hold it flat and just kind of spread the frosting as I go. And you want to be careful you're not pressing too hard while you do this, because you're not trying to shift your cake layers, you're really just trying to smooth out that frosting. So a gentle but firm touch. So we're going to go around and do a few passes. So the first part, I like to just kind of spread, and you can see I'm going to be removing some of that buttercream that we put on. And we're going to just do a few more spins, and if you have any gaps where you see you need a little bit more frosting, you can always fill those in to really get a nice smooth side. However, if you're not trying to get a perfectly smooth side, or if you're going to be covering the cake in something, you can kind of like skip this part, but we are going to be covering the base of the cake, but I like to get those spots kind of filled in. So we're gonna go ahead and do a few more passes here, and then we'll get going on the rest of the decorations. Any other questions?
What's the best way to cut into a cake this tall?
So that is a great question. It is always a little bit of a feat. You'll see once I cut into this in a few minutes what my tactics are, but I think the best advice is to use a very large and a very sharp knife. And to have a lot of people to eat it. And usually people are like, oh my gosh, I can't eat a cake slice that big. But when I serve a cake this tall, I usually cut the layers in half, so only two cake layers would be a serving. And I think that helps a lot too. I also like to heat up my knife usually before I cut into a cake because that helps you get really nice clean cuts. Alright, so now that we have frosted these sides, I'm going to go ahead and clean up the base a little just by scraping with my bench scraper, removing this excess. And we're then going to smooth out the top just by gently pulling in. So if you guys want to see a full in-depth tutorial on how to perfectly frost a cake with smooth sides, I have one up on YouTube, and my YouTube channel is called Chelsweets Bakery, and it shows you, when you have more time and you're not doing it live, the essential steps that you can take to get perfectly smooth sides. So if you want an in-depth tutorial on that, or you struggle with that, feel free to check that out. I'm going to do a few more passes here. We're also going to be adding a border to the top of the cake, so I'm not going to worry about getting it too clean, but we're going to smooth it out a little bit more. Great. All right, so I think I'm going to do one more spin and just see if there's any areas I want to touch up. And then we will get going on our peanut border. I'm just going to scrape off a little bit more here around the base. And now we'll get going on our honey roasted peanuts. So I'm going to go ahead and add some to the base and kind of fade them upwards. And we're going to be using the same honey roasted peanuts we used to fill the cake. And I really like to add the components that a cake is flavored with to the outside, because I think when you look at a cake, you should be able to see what flavor it's going to be and what you're going to be eating. So I'm going to go ahead now using my hands, which I've thoroughly washed, and I'm going to just gently press these around the base. And if you want to, you could place the cake in a baking sheet to avoid having peanuts fall all over your counter and floor. I'm going to be a little live on the dangerous side tonight and not do that, and I guess cover my floor with peanuts. But if you are worried about that, or you just cleaned your kitchen, you can definitely do that. I recommend it. So we're just going to keep going around here, pressing these into the base. And then we're going to add a few more kind of trailing up to almost give it an ombre effect. I don't know if that's possible to do ombre peanuts, but that's kind of what I envision it as. So I think that could be a thing. So again, I'm just gently pressing these in. You don't want to press too hard because you're not trying to dent your frosting, but you do want to press firmly enough to secure it to the cake. So it's kind of a gentle touch. So we're going to keep going around here. And also don't worry if you do by chance dent your frosting. You can always add a bunch of extra peanuts to that area. I feel like cake decorating is all about kind of like problem solving as you go. Like there's always surprises. So don't feel like all hope is lost if that happens. So I'm going to go ahead now and I'm just going to place a few more kind of trailing up the cake in little patches. Give it a fun little look. So like I just accidentally poked my frosting there, so a peanut is going to go there. Problem solved. So we're just going to keep going around and adding a little bit more up here, and then we'll get going on the top of the cake. Are there any other questions out there?
So you mentioned that using a heated knife helps to cut the cake. Mm-hmm. How exactly do you heat up the knife?
That is a great question. So I usually like to run it under hot water, or I have a really tall cup that I fill with super hot water and I let my knife sit in it for about 5 minutes, and then I go ahead and slice. But make sure that you dry off your knife after you wet it. You're not trying to like have a soaking wet knife cut into your cake. But it really does help a lot, so I recommend doing that. I'm gonna do a few more little bits here. And we've actually used up all of our peanuts, which I did not think was gonna happen, so that's fun. All right, so now we have a really fun border around our cake. And a little bit more here. You also, if you wanted to, you could add bits of chocolate around the base. You could really get creative with this and do a lot of different things. So I'll go ahead and set that aside. And now we're going to go ahead and get started on the top of our cake. So using a Wilton 1M tip here, which is just an open star, I'm going to go ahead and pipe kind of some swirls around the top to give it a nice border. And this is just actually regular peanut butter buttercream without any cocoa in it. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of swirl out and then in. So this is just going to be a very classic look. And if you get tired or you kind of want to reposition your hand, you can always take a break. But just take a break once you've finished your swirl. And the idea here is just to make sure that you're consistent with the shape that you're making. And that's how you get a clean looking border. So I'm just kind of piping these little swirls. And we're just going to keep going all the way around the cake until we've completed it. If you wanted to, you could also do buttercream swirls. You could just do nice little spins like that. But I want to kind of mix it up today. So now that we have our border on our cake, the very last step is I'm going to take some of our crushed little bits of chocolate and peanut butter chips, and I'm just going to gently layer them on the center. So this is just going to give it a little bit more color. And again, it lets everyone know what is inside the cake and what they're going to be biting into. So we're almost done with our honey roasted peanut butter cake, and I cannot wait to cut into it and eat it. I think that's going to be the best part. It is a massive cake. Again, if you guys don't want to make a cake this large, you can totally half the recipe or use smaller cake layers to make it. So we're just going to fill this in like that. And just like that, our honey roasted peanut butter cake is complete. So I think now it's time for the very best part. I'm going to go ahead and set my frosting over the side. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to cut into this. So like I was saying earlier, I have here a very large plate for a very large slice and a massive knife. So I'm going to come around to the other side so I can actually cut into it and you can see. But we're going to go ahead and I would like to heat up my knife, but unfortunately I don't want to spend like 5 minutes running the water while you guys are watching. So hopefully this will go through pretty well. We're just going to go ahead and try to cut as straight as we can. And nice and slowly. And then we're gonna pull out. Okay, so I always like to clean off my knife, and I also like to run my knife through twice just to make sure that I really fully cut through. So I think that's pretty good to go. I'm getting really excited about this. Okay, it's almost time. I'm gonna cut a really large slice. There's three friends helping tonight. We can finish a pretty big slice, right?
Definitely.
Okay. Yes. So now we're gonna go ahead and slice in here. And go ahead and remove that. So you can see we have our beautiful thick cake layers that are peanut butter flavored. And you can see our wonderful peanut butter, honey roasted peanut butter buttercream. I'm gonna go ahead and set this down before I drop it. So now I think I'm gonna put it on the side. I feel like it's gonna fall. So now I'm gonna pan back around so you guys can do a full spin of the cake so you can see exactly what it looks like. So this is what it was like before we cut into it and after. So thanks so much for joining me today, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this cake as much as I enjoyed making it. I live stream every Wednesday around 7:45, so if you want to see more of these live streams, tune in next week. If you want to see more of my cake creations, you can also follow me on Instagram, at ChellSweets. And you can also see more of my tutorials on YouTube, which is called ChellSweets Bakery. So hopefully I'll see you guys again next week, and I hope you guys have a great night. See you later.